You emotional as fuck, about to get lost. Fuck your division. It's supposed to be us. They don't ask religion. When they fucking us up, faith is a decision. It shouldn't alter the trust. Is we black or what? Just answer me that. When the shit jumps off, is you running or shooting back? Soldiers come in all shapes, sizes, and strength. Your arrogance disparaging at the smallest offense. You wasn't born with a black fist raised. You awoke, but you can't forget that back in the days you slung coke. I applaud your awakening. It's beautiful to see. Just don't make you no better than me.
What's good, fam? Man, I hate Blog Talk. I tried to change that song for the last show. Wouldn't do it. Changed it back. All of a sudden, it pops up. But I still love that. We ain't going to get into the other one. Let me get AJ on the line right quick. What's good, AJ? What's up, man?
Chilling, man. How you, man?
I'm doing good. Hot as hell, but I'm doing good, man. How's life in D-more?
Hot. Yeah. Pretty hot. What's going on, everybody that's out there? My apologies. You know, that's bad. That's very rude of me to not say what's up to everybody that's listening. You dig what I'm saying? But, yeah, basically the temperature is high. I was getting this last little run on because, you know, summer is about to end. So, go ahead. Let's do what it do. I'm ready for it to get cool outside.
Yeah, I kind of actually enjoy the winter. I'm not going to lie. You know, more so than the summer. I mean, it's certain things in the summer I like, but you can't escape the heat, you know, without increasing my light bill. And then when we do the show, I can't necessarily have the air conditioner on because all you'll hear is the air conditioning. And I keep getting these. Oh, and before we even go any further, man, if you got an active S6 Galaxy like me, you have the trashiest phone in the history of trashy phones. I took the phone back. They sent me another one. Now, they sent me a refurbished new phone, oxymoron. And it's doing the same damn thing. It's like I'm having a conversation, and right in the middle of the conversation, you just can't hear me, so I have to go on speakerphone. It's ridiculous, you know, to the point where I even tweeted their ass. You know, like the next phone I get definitely will not be this trash. I'm just going to put it that way. This is just my experience, you know, with this phone. Even when I called them, though, the lady who I called was like, yeah, we get a lot of complaints about that phone. Horrible. Anyway, man, that's my rant for the day. My bad. You want to give somebody a shout out too, man. Who was that?
Oh, of course. I want to definitely give my homegirl a shout out. It is her birthday today. You feel what I'm saying? I'd like to wish her the most happiest, most wonderful day that she could possibly have. You feel me? I've known her for probably like, say, going on 13 years now. You feel what I'm saying? Very, very, very beautiful person. You feel me? I just wish all the great things in life happen to her. And salute to you, Alice, and enjoy your day.
Salute and happy birthday. And AJ, you got to keep me posted, man, because I hate talking on the speakerphone. So if I happen to go out, let me know.
I got you.
All right. And y'all know, man, if y'all checked the show before, man, this is My Skin Is My Sin on Blog Talk Radio. From goons to gods, we welcome everyone. And we only got one rule, and that's be respectful. And, you know, we tend to show up a little late, you know, and we say it every week, so we just chop it up really about nothing. I will tell you what the topic is today. It's gender wars, you know, and we're just going to chop it up about the relationships between us, men and women. You know, can we fix anything? You know, why is it broken? You know, what's the root causes? You know, what can we do personally to make things a little bit better? And this is a topic that we will probably always touch on because it's so important. You know, a good foundation is the essence of a good community. And if we can do something to improve that foundation, I think we should. You know, that's just my two cents. You there, AJ?
The thing is,
you didn't. Yo, I'm about to say your phone tripping.
Oh, all right. You see, I'm glad you called before I got started. one of the key components as far as building a strong race of people as a whole, for real, is the compliance between the male and the female. Is they both have to have an understanding of not only their role, but how they can support the other one in their role. You feel me? Not one person is bigger than the other. Not one person is more important to these roles. I'm starting to see recently, we could go really far back, but we ain't going to bore y'all as far as going back. I'd say it's probably like the 60s and 70s with the feminist movement. So we're not going to go too far back. But what I'm starting to notice recently, around people around our age, we're starting to see this line. We're starting to see this huge divide. You know, certain females might feel as though they don't need a man for certain things. Certain brothers might feel as though that they don't want a black woman anymore. And it's starting to really confuse things, because on one hand, people ask for empowerment for their people, but they don't want to do it with their people. And this is coming from both sides, male and female.
Right.
And this is a huge hindrance to what's going on. And for some reason, it just seemed like neither side would let up. You know, and what I mean by letting up is just having some leniency, bending but not breaking. You know, that's the key to life right there. And it's like we're fighting ourselves just as hard as we're fighting for the oppressors. And people like me and you looking from the outside, like, what the fuck are y'all arguing about? Like, it's not that serious. But with them being in the midst of it, going back and forth, niggas ain't shit. Y'all girls do this. Y'all tattoos, 4 kids. Well, y'all don't pay child support, all this other stuff. It's when you're looking at it from the outside, looking at it, it looks very foolish. But I'm guessing from the inside, with them fighting amongst each other for real, it just makes all the sense in the world. So basically, what we want to do is we want to get some dialogue going. We want to talk about these things. How can we bring a solution to these problems and just move forward?
I agree. And Queens, we definitely want to hear from y'all tonight. I'm one of those people that I tend to take ownership for the greater good. Even if it's something that I'm not guilty of personally, if I see my brothers doing something, I take ownership of that, you know, to a certain extent. I like to speak from that standpoint. And that being said, I don't think we listen to our women enough. You know, and I find it interesting, you know, you'll listen to your mama for an hour straight, but won't give your woman 10 minutes.
True that.
No disrespect to mom. You know, listen to moms for an hour straight, but why are you not showing your woman that same respect? You know, at some point, you know, and I see a lot of brothers that you know, well, the black woman this, the black woman that, you know, but then call themselves a king. You can't call yourself a king, in my opinion, if you want to blame the kingdom for every ill of society. At what point does your leadership shine through in your relationship where you look inside and say, okay, I set the tempo in my household. How do I go about setting a better tempo? You know, and I think that right there, and I'm not saying that that's going to solve every problem in every relationship. However, that will minimize the larger problems. Y'all still going to argue about the toilet seat? You might. But that argument about the toilet seat won't turn into her throwing your shit out or you saying you got to go or whatever, you know, World War III. Because that's how the little things turn into huge problems, is when you ignore things and you don't talk to each other, and more importantly, you're not listening. And it doesn't even have to be listening to what she's saying. It's listening to what she's showing. You know, we all know, you know, when your woman stops talking, it's a wrap for you, bruh.
Thanks.
You know, a good woman gives you a whole lot of opportunity to fix shit.
Call them warning signs.
And I know myself. Huh?
They call them warning signs.
Yeah.
Most people usually say when the relationship over, like, damn, I knew she was mad. Yeah, it's too late now. But go ahead.
Facts. You know, I just know from you know, I failed in relationships. You know, who hasn't? You know, and that's what you learn from, though. Because to a certain extent, you pick, at least from my experience, you pick a certain type of person, not the same person, but certain things about them kind of like translate to the next person. And if you find yourself doing that, you got two things you can do, you know, to have a better relationship, at least, you know, and I'm no expert, so don't sue me or anything like that. But you can either kind of step outside your comfort zone and totally go for somebody different, or you can evaluate what you did in that failed relationship to produce that failure, so that the next time you encounter that same scenario, you don't repeat the same thing. You know, I know it's a lot of people out there who'd have had somebody, an ex, and you was arguing with them about the same thing, and now you and the person you with, y'all arguing about the same thing, and it's like, okay, why do I keep having the same argument? What part are you contributing to that argument is the question. And not to say that you're always wrong. You don't have to necessarily be wrong to realize that you contributed. You know, sometimes you got to get up and say, you know what, I love you enough to step outside, cool off for a second, and come back in, and we can finish this dialogue. Because I see where this is going, and I want to change this. I'm not being disrespectful. If anything, I respect you enough to stop myself, gather myself, and realize this is the person I love, and I need to make sure I'm not, A, saying something that I can't take back, or B, saying things out of just total emotion that you know you're not thinking about. You know, and that's, I guess that would be my Dr. Phil moment, or whoever you want to say. You know, but hey,
yeah, I say in this day and age, for real, like, I look at it like this. The best thing to do for real is to basically come together. And what I mean by that is black functional relations. It's for a lot of reasons, but for the simple fact that the same stereotypes that we hear about all women and that they hear about all men, if you try to venture out and date outside of your race, they hear these same things as well. You dig what I'm saying? And, of course,
mm-hmm.
like majority of them, they're going to stay true to their core base. Nobody else is going to really love you like a black person do. 98.99999% of the time, whether male or female. You dig what I'm saying? And the thing is, we have to kill these stereotypes. But I see so many. Well, I got all my brothers for this. I see so many of my brothers using these stereotypes against black women. I have no idea who these women that they're talking about are. They just hear things and then they regurgitate these things. You know, like just like the past couple of years, I've been hearing this huge war on weeds. When have black men, I don't know what just fell, I hope your foot all right, because it sounded like it was loud. I've been hearing...
Yeah, I closed the window, bro.
Oh, wow, I was about to say, hope your fingers all right, I'd be like, doom. But I've been hearing, I call it WOW, the war on weeds. Like, when have black men became stylists? Like, that's what I want to know. Oh, my gosh, she got that yakky number two. How do you know that? Like, how do you know that? Like, when you get into a full-fledged debate and there's nothing but brothers around and they're talking about a woman's hair, something is wrong with what we've been taught and what we're regurgitating like this is supposed to be normal. Of course, I am down with the natural movement 100%. I love my women with natural hair. But if they decide to wear something that they feel comfortable with and it doesn't look tacky for real, who am I to argue with? It's not on my head. It's not on mine. You feel what I'm saying? If I want to go to the club with a RoboCop helmet on, if it make me feel comfortable, my significant other is going to rock with it. She might tell me it looks stupid, but I'm being that bitch looking like Murphy.
with the RoboCop helmet.
That's a reach, man.
Just making
it. Your woman, the club with you looking like RoboCop.
I hope not. Try and bring light to the situation, brother. Work with me. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I honestly get tired of that. You feel what I'm saying? Like, we beat each other down. I say this all the time. We beat each other down because we feel as though that we're the easiest targets to basically attack. And we kind of are. Not realizing that we're in this shit together. We're making it kind of easier for other people to attack and ridicule us. You know? And some of the females, they can disrespect somebody just off of a look or a stereotype as well. I feel as though if you're going to be submissive to anybody or just be more open-hearted or more, just more open to somebody, it should be mm-hmm. your fellow black man or black woman. You feel what I'm saying? That should be the first option right there. You dig what I'm saying? Like, you don't know what this sister went through. You don't know what this brother went through. You feel what I'm saying? But it's a group of us out here. I ain't going to say us because I'm not included in it. It's men that's like on a tear. You feel what I'm saying? Of trying to destroy black women's psyche, their ego, emotionally, spiritually, and I seen that video. The dude that ran into the chick car, talking about he'd beat a black bitch ass, is about to get physical. You dig what I'm saying? Like, that's
wow.
Crazy. I know you've seen the video I'm talking about.
I don't think I've seen that one, bro.
Oh, man, I know.
Yeah.
Seriously,
if you call
a caller, call
tag me in that one.
I want you to sleep well tonight. I might tag you to it in the morning. You're going to be heated. I'm telling you, you're going to be heated. Like, man, I will break this dude's neck. You feel what I'm saying? Like, it was that bad. On a female tip as well, I have no problem with anybody that you date. If you feel like dating outside of your race is what you like, that's what you want to do. If you do it from a place where as though you're not following a fad or you're not doing it out of spite, I can't be mad at that. I don't go to sleep with you. I don't care. But I come across all these websites, swirling.com and all these other things, encouraging other people to not date black men. Not find the best black men, but just not date them at all. I don't see that for other races of people. And I feel like that's why other races of people, especially in America, are so strong, and we are so weak as a unit. We could be strong individually, but as a unit, we're kind of weak.
You know, I got the numbers in front of me, too. Because what I did was, and this is from the Pew Research Center, and this is as of 2013, 25%. Of newlyweds in 2013, black men married outside their race, and 12% black women. The highest number was amongst American Indians. 61% of their women marry outside their race. Asians were second with 37% of their women and 16% of their men. And white people were equal, 7% for both. Why, you know, what is it that is encouraging that? Is it people trying to assimilate? Is it what you said, you know, what you were saying earlier about the stereotypes and people falling victim to it? And you know what, another thing I find interesting is that when a man does say, you know what, men can do better, you will hear so many other brothers clown them about that. You know, what about the women? What about the women? I wish we could just stop that type of conversation, just my opinion, and at some point say, you know what, let's just focus on us.
Right, let's take accountability.
Let's focus
on
what we
can
fix.
Mm-hmm.
Women focus on what they can fix because, you know, make no mistake about it, it's two sides to every coin. You know, are there some things that the sisters can do better? Of course. You know, but, again, we are supposed to be the leaders. You know,
yes.
So with that being said, why aren't we leading in that area?
I mean, going by the numbers that you put out there, it seems like we're running. It seems like we're running because we're definitely leading the women.
You can't deny that.
Can't deny it.
You know, it is what it is. And then people don't want to hear that, you know. And as soon as you bring it up, you know, everybody, you know, is people take a side. And hold on 1 second, man. Let me get Roman on the line, too. And you know what? And shout out to Deeper Than Oceans in the chat room. Before I get Roman, I kind of just want to read her comment. I feel he is real, what was just said. Many of the black men who have not self-assessed downgrade and defame and try to destroy their woman's character. And mostly it is hidden behind closed doors. You know, and what you said about leading is needed. You know, salute to you for that comment. And let me get Roman on the conversation. What's good, fam?
Yo, peace, family.
Peace.
What's the word?
Yeah, man, we in here, we talking about gender wars, man. And Jarv just ran down the numbers. It's not looking good for brothers, man. We're marrying outside our race at 25%. So basically we're leading all of our races as far as stepping out.
I mean, can we all agree as a whole that black men have evolved into what's the proper term? Inner coons?
Inner queens?
Inner coon.
I got the perfect term for you, for real. We're modern day bucks.
It's right.
Modern day bucks.
Facts. I'll say it from this point. I understand. All right, so let me make my disclaimer first. All right. I've dated outside of my race before in my early 20s. You know what I'm saying? So I've been on both sides of the shoe, but I married a black woman. You understand? I married a black woman. I dated outside of my race before. It don't compare. I mean, if you really want to keep it real, they both got on my fucking nerves. You know what I'm saying? It didn't. You know, it was different. You know what I mean? Because I mean, as you know, my wife, though. You know what I mean? You know my wife. You know, so it was different. That's the mother of my child. But I understand where brothers are coming from as far as frustration dealing with some of the sisters. But I ain't doing it. I can't. I can't. You know what I'm saying? I can't do it. I just kind of feel like you can't never really fully understand where that individual coming from because y'all don't come from the same shit. You know what I mean? It's a different struggle. It's a different feel. It's almost even a different type of love. You literally as a black man gotta think. Do this bitch really love me, or am I just a token nigga for her? You know what I'm saying? Or does she just want some big dick? You know
are
what I mean?
You
like,
are you feeding her fetish? Pretty much. That's what you gotta think about. Because let's be honest. A lot of them got fetishes.
Facts. Yo, it's not, I ain't gonna say every, but it is definitely a token white woman fetish to be with a black man. You know what I'm saying? That's definitely a fetish, and it's not. You might get a few that say I have no interest. That's bullshit. You understand what I'm saying? Like it's complete bullshit. Like every woman at some point in time has desires or thinks about sleeping with a black man. And I mean, we all know what it is. You know what I'm saying? I mean, we all know what that's about. You know what I mean? I mean, the Washington Monument is an ode to Osiris' penis. Bruh, you know what I'm saying? Like, you talking about the nation's capital. You talking about some shit that the country was built off of. You know what I'm saying? This was shit that was in white people's minds hundreds of years ago when they first pulled up and they seen our peoples out there dick swinging and shit. You know what I'm saying? Niggas out there fishing and shit. You know what I'm saying? Nigga whole wood hanging in the river and shit. They was like, what the fuck going on? You know what I mean? You go back and then take them to where they open on the open market and being sold, and they standing there stripped butt naked, you know what I'm saying? And it's a brother shit hanging down to his knee. Of course you're going to be intrigued. You know what I mean? I mean, it's real, though. It's deep-rooted, though.
I get what y'all saying, you know, but, again, you know, we got to take some ownership of that because, these ain't shotgun weddings we talking about. There's brothers out here just, like, openly courting. You know, and like AJ said, like who you fall in love with is who you fall in love with. However, when you do so at the expense of your whole race, when you cut off your race and oh, sisters ain't this. I never, you know, and you see it. I never date a sister. She this, she that. You know, okay, you are tripping, bro. You got some issues that you really need to deal with before you call yourself loving anybody.
Facts.
That something is inherently wrong with you. Somebody hurt you. You need to get that fixed. You know, where you just want to cut off all sisters for some bad relationships you had with a couple, because there's no way possible that you have met every black woman, but you making a call on every black woman. That's not every black woman. That's you.
Yeah, that's Tommy Sotomayor shit. Coon ass nigga.
See, yeah, I mean, and that's the thing. You feel like, the ties have reversed. You feel what I'm saying? Like, now it's kind of, I don't know how it feels to Coon. You feel what I'm saying? Like, the Coon, they wake up, yawn, put on some tap dance shoes, and like, you feel what I'm saying? Do a shimmy down to my front door. Like, it's openly cool to Coon now. You feel what I'm saying? Like brothers will really put out there everything that they hate about black women to anybody that'll listen. It doesn't matter if they're black, Hindunese, Chinese, spaceman, dragon from the Lost Lagoon. They talk to anybody bad about black women. You feel what I'm saying? It's like, it's almost cool now. You dig what I'm saying? And that makes us as an entire race look weak as hell. You feel what I'm saying? It not only does it make us look weak, it makes us look real foolish. You dig what I'm saying? Because you never met every single black woman on this earth. You feel what I'm saying? And I can say that for the females as well, but we're gonna clean out this backyard first. We got time today, cuz. You feel what I'm saying?
Let's call it for what it is, though. Like, that falls
on
a black man.
It's a follower's mentality.
That falls on a black man for not protecting the queen. I mean, that's the ultimate goal in chess. You know what I mean? That's a cliche saying. This chess, not checkers. You know what I'm saying? Like, I understand that. Yeah, it's a lot of brothers that's dating outside their race. One, they have no knowledge of self. Two, some of them just tired of dealing with them. You know what I'm saying? And three, it really depends on where you live.
That's the whole thing. See, now if we was to put that in perspective, you feel what I'm saying? Then we could just make the whole argument: what came first, the chicken or the egg? Because we say that black men was not protecting black women, or they're tired of their BS. We could just easily flip that on his head and just say, when black women became feminists, that's the reason why we got tired of it. So we don't even want to get into that argument. But I do get what you're saying. Let's deal with the ill. No, go ahead.
That right there. Let me interject on that one right there. Hold on for one second, Ron, because when people bring up the whole, when black women became feminists, you know, like, a lot of times, at least from what I have seen, they put the onus totally on the sisters. And I remember reading about the sisters and the Panthers. And, man, love the Panthers, salute to them. What they had issues with was the expectations placed upon them as far as the movement was concerned. You know, they not only was
their leadership
and
roles,
but they had to cook, they had to do this, they had to do that, and it's almost like we not listening. You know, there have been throughout history, you go all the way back to Africa, there have been the strongest of strong women who have led nations. Not only led nations, but led nations into war. You know, now I'm not saying I don't appreciate a good ass meal, and I love it coming home and there is something cooked. But I also understand, especially in today's society, that's not practical all the time. You know, I don't want to come home. I didn't put in my 8 hours. She come home, put in her 8 hours, and then I want her to put in another 4.
Well, I mean,
you
see, a lot of people that look at it,
I
a lot of people
somewhere halfway.
Yeah, because you're looking at it logical.
You got compromise on that one. Yeah,
you're looking at it logical. But see the thing is the way. I'm glad that you brought up the Panthers, because it was a lot. It was very hard for females to get up in rank. That's why people like Afeni Shakur is held to the highest prestige. You dig what I'm saying? It was certain things that they did had to do, but you have to understand also, even though these brothers was black, militant, and thought black first, you feel what I'm saying? Power to the people. That's still Europeanized. They're still Europeanized. They're not bringing African tribal instincts and all these other things to America because they didn't know nothing about them. Only thing they knew about what was given to us by the Europeans. You dig what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So they wasn't doing it because they didn't value the black woman. You feel what I'm saying? I can understand because the black woman is so strong. She was like, nigga, we're equal. But at the same, it's like we are, but in different fields. You dig what I'm saying? We are equal, but it's just certain things that'll balance us out. You dig what I'm saying? Because, I want you to know how to use a gun, but I don't want you right next to me when the shit pop off. I want you to be the second line of defense if necessary. You feel what I'm saying? So I wouldn't want you out there like, this. We got this. So when it's time for you to put them potatoes and slice that up, let me be the second line of defense. You feel what I'm saying? I do the dishes, goddammit. You feel what I'm saying? I mean, so that should be an even trade. But the reason why I brought up the whole feminist movement is because a lot of black women was duped at that time for real because white women felt as though they wasn't being treated a certain way by their men, and they just went to black women like, hey, ain't, don't you feel this way? And some of them, not all. Some of them, not all, was like, I feel you. Not knowing that white women were still going home to their men. They were still going home to their men. Black women were just like, fuck this. You feel what I'm saying? We got this. Bobby, stay your ass outside, Bobby. We got this. You feel what I'm saying? And that's where the disarray came in, if we want to talk about it. But it's 2016 now. We can't let these things carry over. And that's what a lot of people were still carrying over from back then, using it as an excuse to treat black women wrong. That's why I don't want to bring that up from back then. You dig what I'm saying?
I agree. And, you know, what I'm hearing from a lot of sisters now is that they don't feel that we are protecting them.
Well, they got a point. We're all being affected by systematic white supremacy.
It's bigger than that, though. Like, it's not just about it, even though it's always about white supremacy, we got to take accountability in that shit, too, bro. Like, you got brothers who will sit up there and make a song about and talk about how much they hate a bitch. You know what I'm saying? How much a bitch ain't shit.
I agree.
Yeah, how much a bitch ain't shit. And go into and indulge deeper. I mean, take for instance Eminem. Eminem makes songs about killing his baby mother, bro. You know what I'm saying? And nobody talks about it. Let a brother make a song about killing this baby mother and it be graphic. And I hate this bitch, and you big butt black bitch, et cetera. Pick a song, you know what I'm saying? And in which this type of dialogue is taking place. Like, bro, nobody's saying anything about it. Like, it's bullshit. Like, I just think that at the end of the day, we got to take that. We got to hold the L as black men.
We already covered that ground. But once again, this is how it falls back to systematic white supremacy. If you want to make two people divide, how would you do that? You feel what I'm saying? Rap music is the most predominant music out there right now, right? Who pushes it? Who makes these bullshit songs pop for real? You feel what I'm saying?
Right.
Who makes these songs pop? You feel like, put it like this. But see, this is the thing. You feel what I'm saying? Repetition works over and over and over and over again. I say this all the time. For real. No other music or genre out there that ever existed defiled and defamed black any group of people the way rap music does. This is a fact. You feel what I'm saying? But the problem about it is, if that shit wasn't popping, we wouldn't hear from it no more. The reason why it's popping because you have big wigs over us that's putting it out there. If you want to make money fast, you live in a deprived neighborhood. You want to get the fuck out of here. You want a big chain and a nice car. Make a song about all these women right here and just say that you don't like dark skinned girls. You like light skinned girls.
Now, in the interest of fairness, you may not be country music goes hard on their women too. In the interest of fairness,
they do.
I just had to throw that out there. They go hard on their women and they talk a lot of shit about them too, bro. I'm just saying.
Man, they talk about that dog being their best friend too, for real, man. So they can have that. They can get as drunk as they want to. You feel what I'm saying? When they push with that dog rocket and be mad at that girl that left them. I'm cool with that. This in-house time. This in-house time. You feel me? I honestly get pissed off myself because when I got knowledge of self and got old, I'm like, Like, did this brother really just say that about a whole entire group of chicks? Like, damn, you feel what I'm saying? Like, this doesn't sound the same. You feel me? Like, I heard a song by Kevin Gates on Pandora. You feel what I'm saying? When I was at work one day, this was probably like last year or something. And the whole song was dedicated to him beating up his girlfriend. And the song was catchy.
Wow.
Like, if you hear the song and just listen to the beat, you're like, oh, that's, this shit sound all right. You feel what I'm saying? Like, this shit tough. But then you listen to the lyrics, you're like, yo, say, I hit you with the left jab because the right one doesn't miss you. Ugh. I'm like, whoa, like, no, nah, man, turn this shit off for real. I can't listen to this.
What's the name of that song? We Supposed to Be in Love.
Yup, exactly. You know what I'm talking about.
We Supposed to Be in Love, yeah.
That shit it's kind of fire if
yeah,
you want it dope.
We Supposed to Be in Love.
Yeah,
in love.
You feel what I'm saying? But think about, but think about the young Fumana that listen to that, or any Lil Boosie song. Like, Lil Boosie is like the man in Maryland. You feel what I'm saying? All he raps about is yellow balls. You feel what I'm saying? It's been on the count, on the count, on the count of rappers that came out and said, I don't like dark butts. This is just totally disrespecting all women. Defiling them, and they're even going to go one of two ways. Either they're going to be subservient to this bullshit, or they're just going to say, I don't want to deal with black men altogether.
And to that end, I got a question for the queens out there that are listening. We've been talking a lot about what we can do as the men. What is it you think that women can do better? Because I don't want to step out and speak for you, you know, and you don't necessarily have to call a radio station. If you want to, it's 347-855-8692. You got to press 1. But you can make a comment in the chat room. You can make a comment in the event. You can inbox me. I don't care. You know, but I do want to know, what do you think from a woman's standpoint that women can do better to facilitate us coming together and bringing our family structure back?
Take initiative.
So
I hate to say it like that, but if we're dealing with, I mean, let's be real, we're dealing with a society where the male has been feminized. You know what I mean? So certain things, certain things that you would expect from a female standpoint that you would expect a man to do, you got to be on point. You got to be on point exactly where that brother is mentally. You know what I mean? Or how he was raised. He might not be accustomed to it. He might not be used to it. So in certain situations, as far as bringing the family closer together, I think that is an obligation on both parts to make it work. You know what I'm saying? It's not up to me. It's up to us. You know what I mean? That's up to God. But I mean, black man and woman together is God. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? It's up to us to create that paradigm. You know what I mean? You got to change the culture of thinking in a household, and that's got to take place between the man and woman.
Now, I will say, and I say this all the time. You know, just from personal experience, the biggest help for me is when my woman knows this is not the time to say that. And I'm not saying, you know, I don't want, I've never wanted a weak woman. I want a woman that has no problem telling me, baby, that's not a good look. However, when she says that and how she says that are crucial. You know, we out at dinner with a whole bunch of people. You know, that's not the time to be telling me that's not a good look openly. If you want to say, hey, baby, let's go outside for a second. Or, you know what, walk me up to the bar, let's go get a drink. You know, do something like that so you can say, hey, you know what, this is not a good look, baby. You might want to do this, X, Y, and Z. You know, but when you want to put it out on Front Street, you know, it's kind of like your parents. You know, what happens in your house stays in your house. But what happens in your relationship should stay in your relationship if there's some, you know, some correction that needs to be made. And I think that's a huge thing because you end up turning, you know, something that could be handled internally and easily into a long-lasting effect. Because then the man feels like, you know what, I don't have the freedom to discuss certain things with my woman because you undercutting me in front of people.
And that leads to looking for outlets.
Yeah.
And that leads to him smashing your cousin. You know what I'm saying? Like, I mean, it's real though, and that's why communication is so vital. Like, one thing I learned through my personal experiences is that you and your spouse define your relationship, not nobody else and whatnot. You know, it's no manual on this shit. You know what I'm saying? There's not a universal, there ain't no Acme book to a healthy relationship. You know what I mean? So your trials and tribulations through whatever you guys endure, you guys define what your relationship is. There's no laws. There's nothing that's going to get you arrested, you know what I'm saying, for maintaining your relationship how you want your relationship maintained. You know what I mean? And that's what it boils down to. It's communication and just making sure you guys are on par with, I mean, a lot of things from a moral, mental, and spiritual standpoint.
And you know what? I saw an article, actually, I don't know, about a half an hour ago. And just the title of the article, it was a young lady, she was 22, and she said, it was a young sister, she said she won't date a brother with a credit score under 700.
Bro. I like that article. Did you read the article?
And I didn't get a chance to read the article. You know how I do when I get ready for the show. But just the title alone, initially I'm thinking to myself, like, well, you know, that's ridiculous. And then as I thought, you know, I'm tagging folks and doing, you know, just prepping for the show and whatnot. And I got to thinking about it. And it started making sense. Like, why, you know,
yeah.
Like, why shouldn't she have high standards? Because if you think about it, like, you got a dude out in the street selling dope. At the end of the day, you know what he's selling dope for? Is to attract women. Because he feels that he needs to have stuff to attract women. Now, if women said, you know what, I'm not going to deal with a drug dealer. You know, kind of like, what was Spike Lee's movie? The one that shot in Chi-Raq.
Yeah.
You know, they basically went on strike to get their men together. Now, I'm not going to make a comment about, you know, whether I like the movie or not. However, that premise.
It was terrible. Call it for what it was. It was terrible.
No, it was not. No. If you think about
it. I thought it was terrible,
Most of the stuff that men do, especially young men, is for attention from women. But if they are giving attention to the negative aspect, then the men are going to continue to do that. If women only dated dudes that went to school, dudes that respected their mother, and dudes that did not sell dope, I wonder how much dope would be sold. And the flip side of that is my first daughter, I realized that her mother and I, we just had a toxic relationship. We really did. So after her, I said, you know what? I'm going to find a good mother. In the event that I have children with her, I want to find a good mother first. I set up requirements.
Right.
So I looked to that end, and I had two more daughters with that woman that I found. However, I set a standard. That was important to me. So I think that on both sides, we need to set standards as opposed to saying, you know, and I know that there's a, as far as the ratio of men to women, you know, the eligible black men, especially eligible employed black men, there are more women than men. I get that, you know. However, if on both sides we start setting a standard, I think, and this is, you know, it's no, nothing scientific, just my opinion, but I think that we would start to reap the benefits of that. If we holding each other accountable, we both have to do better.
Yeah, I seen the article you were talking about with the chick that said she don't want to date nobody with a credit score under 800.
And I read the article because it caught my attention. I seen the one that the dark skinned female. For one, she's 22 years old, and in the first within the first paragraph, she already said that she has a credit score already over 800. You feel what I'm saying? So basically, she's doing pretty well for herself. So she basically wants somebody to meet her halfway. You feel? I feel as though that if a lot of relationships was built that way, it would be a lot less confusion of things that's going on right now. You feel what I'm saying? Like, because there's a lot of things that we do first before we think about things that's going to last with us for the rest of our lives in general. You feel what I'm saying? Like, procreate. That's one thing. I'm not saying that children aren't a blessing because they are, but the relationship between the parents of that child that was here, that was brought as a blessing, can basically manipulate that child for real to act, feel, and have an emotional just allergy towards anything that's positive. Like, they'd just be attracted to anything that's toxic and negative because that's all they seen. You know, like, think about it. Like, how many times you ever heard somebody say, I hit my girl because I see my father slap my mother? You feel what I'm saying? That's the offspring of a toxic relationship. So with her having standards, I'm just going to use as you feel what I'm saying, as the ground base. With her having such high standards, because she cares about herself that much, she's going to meet somebody that's going to meet her halfway, and hopefully she makes an idea. Because if I see her 3 years down the line with another article, like the girl that says she'll decide with under 800 credit score is with a dusty dude, I'm going to be pissed. You feel what I'm saying? Because I like the premises of it, and I like the idea of it, and I think that that's holding yourself accountable, because you do pick who you're supposed to, you pick who you want to be with.
The question is she going to show a brother how to get the score? You know what I'm saying? Like,
she wants you to already have it.
Well, that's the problem. Everybody don't know how to get it. I don't believe that article off the rip anyway.
But you know what?
I don't believe none of that.
Let me ask you this though.
But you know,
why is she responsible to show him responsibility?
No, I'm not saying she's responsible for showing it to him. Is she willing to show it to him if he doesn't know it?
I mean, I look at it like this from the way that the article went for real. Like, if you don't have it, she ain't even going to deal with you. And that's kind of that's arrogant,
bruh,
in the opinion.
Bruh,
but
I've had conversations with women like this, bro. Like, I don't believe it. I just don't. Like, it's easy to say you get an article, and I guarantee you ain't got nobody. I guarantee you, if she says she won't date you because of that, just imagine what else. What if you got a felony? You know what I'm saying?
It was more thing, but that was just the title with
I didn't read the article, so I will be honest and say that. But I'm just saying, I've heard that said before about all that standard shit. You with them in person, that whole, and we all know, man. We've all had one of them joints before. That shit goes out the window, bro. That shit's not real.
It was something to say when men got standards, because we all got standards. Ours is just usually physically based.
Facts.
Nobody really go. You know, some dudes like a big fat ass. You know, if a dude likes a big fat ass and won't date a chick without a big fat ass, nobody besmirches him because he likes a big fat ass. You know, nobody says, you know, you should lower your standards or whatever. You know, what you get is a cheering section. Man, I understand that. Blase, splee, blase, splee. But on the flip side, when a woman has some standards, it's like, well, you know what, you're going to have to lower your standards. Why? Why should she have to lower her standards?
Know,
now, I understand.
You know,
now, one thing is, I think people misconstrue is her saying you got to have a high credit score with having, you know, making $100,000 a year. You can work at McDonald's and have a high credit score.
True.
You know, I've seen a lot of people that don't make a lot of money who don't go above their means, live wisely, and are really successful.
Yeah, the key to having a good credit score is just knowing your restrictions, pretty much. You feel what I'm saying? Like, that's showing self-restraint. You dig what I'm saying?
Yeah.
The thing about her request and the reason why I really don't have too much of an opinion on her request, it's because it's something tangible. It's something tangible. You feel what I'm saying? Now, if her request was like, I won't date a nigga if his rims ain't on 23s and up. You would look at her like, this black Nubian queen is fucking retarded. Like, what the fuck? That makes no sense.
Right.
You feel me? But
yeah, I definitely get that.
You see, like, this is a little bit more tangible, so I'm not too mad at that. Will she ever break out of it? I don't know. Do I want her to break out of it? Truthfully, no. Because, like, we got to look at it back in the old days, like, really, really back, like, back in the day for real. Like, it was ordained marriages. You feel me? Like, they wanted to keep this. They wanted to keep this type of family with this type of family. Was it fucked up? Did those two people like each other? No. But did they keep the thing circulating? Did they keep the money circulating? Did they keep the power circulating? Yes. So it might kind of come to a point where it's on the black community where something similar might have to happen. Keep the good, the strong, powerful, ambitious black people on this side. And if you want to be bummy, you might got to stay over here to preserve our race. We can't have you affecting the good people with your bumminess and dustiness. And I hate to say it like that. Until you get yourself undusty, you got to come over here. You feel me? And I don't want to say it like that, but, like, you know I'm making sense. I'll say it for you. Dusty,
no,
to the left.
No, I agree with you to an extent. And the reason I'm saying to an extent is I think that what we aren't doing as a community early on is teaching life skills. Good life skills. We're teaching life skills, and a lot of times we're teaching bad life skills. And, you know, we don't really talk about paying bills with our children. You know, we don't really talk about credit scores with our children.
How to balance a checkbook,
filing taxes.
You know, right.
Right. You know, and right. I think that we need to do a better job not only teaching them. Like, I remember when I was a kid, my mother had me walk to the gas company to pay the bill. And you know what I did? I lost the money on the way. She never
had
me
again.
Yeah,
you
still alive? Yes, I am. It was not a good look. You know, and it was not like I went out and bought candy or went out and bought a bike and hit it. I legitimately lost it. And I guess my moms could, you know, and I was hurt by that. You know, and you know, your moms know when you're lying. You know, and she just took the L. You know, I'm going to keep it a stack. But what she didn't do was continue to have me doing that. And then looking back, you know, that's something that would have been beneficial to me for her to say, okay, you know what, or to walk with me and say, this time, this is how you do it, blase split, and then send me again. Because now my confidence was a little broke. You know, I had a really, that was my first important task, and I failed. But I never got the opportunity again. You know, and so we also got to let our kids fail and still hold their hand after they failed a little bit and say, you know what, I know you fell off. I'm going to pick you up, and we're going to try again. And then I'm going to give you that same opportunity because I not only was I disappointed at that moment, but that disappointment stuck with me because I wasn't allowed the opportunity to fix that. You know, so I think that, and even if you want to start off with Monopoly money, you know, if you got a 5-year-old, you know, this is how daddy pays the bills. You know, this is your money. You know, this is how we do it. You know, you have to pay this by a certain time, and you have to make sure that you don't go out and waste your money. And when you do that from an early age, a woman doesn't have to train you, so to speak, manage your money. You back on, Ron.
I totally agree with that.
We got to do a better job of setting our children up for success. And that's on both sides. That is men and women. You know, it doesn't take, you know, however y'all work y'all house, if it's just, let's just say he works and she stays at home with the children and she manages the books, or y'all both work, you know, and y'all work on the books together, involve your kids. Let them see. You know, and a lot of people, what they do is they want to hide the struggle. Why are you hiding the struggle? When you hide the struggle, you are setting your kids up to repeat that struggle. You know, I'm not saying that your children need to know every intricate detail of your relationship, but with respect to how to manage your money, They need to know. And not only will they appreciate knowing, they'll appreciate the struggle that you and your spouse or whoever went through to get them in a better position in life. You know, a lot of people, you know, it's unfortunate, but a lot of people will go out and buy their kids some J's and won't pay a bill.
Facts.
What you teaching your kid? You know, you got your kid is 6 years old and they got three bills in their name. How is that fair? And I understand that you got to do what you got to do. I get that. You know, but why are you putting that onus on your child that has absolutely no knowledge of that until they turn, you know, 21, 22, go to get their first apartment, and they like, bro, you got a $2,000 light bill. I never had no lights on in my name. And that has happened. You know, there's a lot of people out there that got bad credit before they had credit, before they knew about credit.
Right.
You know? And that is the cycle of not being taught how to manage your money.
So basically, I feel as though that the sister is what she's doing as far as what she look at requires her standards. It's not necessarily a bad thing. It just might come off really arrogant. You feel what I'm saying? It could come off that way,
yeah.
But I'm not upset with that. Her standards are way more tangible than saying that she like a dude with a sleeve. You feel what I'm saying? A sleeve all full of tattoos, gold teeth, smoke nothing with the loudest of the loud. You feel what I'm saying? Like that's not going to help us preserve as a race.
All that out. Just to touch on that real quick, like all I was saying with that was, in situations in which financial literacy hasn't been taught, you know what I'm saying, and which because you have a lot of people like that, and those I didn't learn how to write a check, bro, until I was like in my 20s, you know what I'm saying. Let alone like I learned that shit on my own, you know what I mean. Like this type of shit wasn't taught to me. I learned
right.
it on my own. I learned it through trial and error. You know what I'm saying? So what I'm saying is for people who haven't had that financial literacy passed down to them from their mother, father, whoever, that hasn't been taught to them, and you bump into this individual in life, you're going to try to tell me that you're not going to fuck with me because my credit fucked up, but I didn't even know what the fuck credit was or how to obtain it or how to maintain it. Man, get out of here. We're gonna take this Ciroc. We're gonna go hit this room. You're gonna get knocked off. That's what's gonna happen. Like that's the type of chicks that say blatant statements like that.
I mean, or
you know what I'm saying?
You could say, you know what? How about this? Instead of the Ciroc and knocking her off in the room, you could say, you know what? I respect that. How about I show you my credit score? We don't, you know, we don't get into a relationship, and you school me on how to fix it.
That will be an excellent point, but she's not saying that.
Right.
She's not. Right. You know what I'm saying? She's not saying that. So it just comes off. It comes off extremely arrogant when someone would say, "I won't date nobody," you know what I mean, unless they got over a credit score of 700. Like, what does your credit look like? You know, look, first of all, like you better have at least a 750. Do you know what I mean? To be asking me something like that. That's
and
how
I
feel.
Agree with that, you know.
You know what I'm saying?
I agree with that. I can understand both sides of the fence on that one. I can understand her saying, you know what, if she has a 750 credit score, I really don't want to do it with a 400 credit score. Now, if, like I said, y'all happen to meet and for, you know, y'all click. For whatever reason, you know, maybe she said, you know what, we're not going to date, but for whatever reason, I'm feeling you, I will give you the opportunity to fix what you got wrong. It may not even end up with y'all dating, but you'll always be grateful for that game she gave you. You know, now it will take a little give on her part to at least have a conversation, and she could be upfront. Look, I'm not going to date anybody under the 700 credit score. Okay, I get that. We at the bar, we get to chopping it up, and she tell me that. And if I say, you know what, I feel that. I respect you. You know what, I want a woman with a 750 credit score as well, and I'm one of those dudes that got a poor credit score. Can you help me so that I can be a better person in the future and find a woman with that standard. If you put it out to her like that, I would venture to guess that she would be more than willing to help. Because everything looked bad in a news report or in a sound bite, because that don't capture the total essence of a person. Yes, we all have standards. Yes, we all got rules that we don't want broken. Everybody say that, you know. Everybody say, I ain't dealing with somebody that cheat in the beginning. You know, it just depends on the dynamics of the two of y'all, and it don't, even if it's not a relationship, it could be, but it couldn't be. But if you can get a good dialogue and a little help, because myself, you know, 10 years ago, a woman said that to me, fuck her. I'm going to keep it a stack. But that didn't, you know what, I just potentially let a good source of knowledge get away. Because how many people, if I have a 400 credit score, let's keep it a stack, how many people am I going to really come in contact with a 750 credit score?
I mean, that's true.
So knowing that, if I got you in a situation where I can pick your brain, at the very least, I want to do that so I can better my future and figure out how to get my shit back up to a respectable level. Not even for her, because we all know, especially nowadays, they'll run your credit for a damn cell phone. You know, you want to get car insurance, they running your credit. They run AT&T sent a thing in the mail that said not only will they run your credit score to get a cell phone, but let's say you got somebody on your account. If they just log into your account to check your account, they're going to run your credit score.
Wow.
Right. You know, and this is some new policy that they enacted. You know, so and when people say don't be so emotional, don't be so emotional, you know, that would be one of those times where I say, you know what, I need to not be so emotional about what she's saying and find out how she got to that spot. With that being said, though, before we go any further, I want to let y'all know y'all tuned in to My Skin Is My Sin on Blog Talk Radio. From goons to gods, we welcome everyone. Y'all already know, man. We only have one rule, and that's be respectful. Oh, and don't forget to check out the groups, All Black Everything and My Skin Is My Sin. And we started a new group today, the Black Polling Center. And it, basically all we're doing is polls so we can try to take away some of the propaganda that's been put out there as far as how black people think. Let's control that agenda. Anyway, we can get back to it. My bad, fellas. I had to get that out there, though.
If anybody knows the sister who actually quoted, who actually had the article, have her email goonstogods@gmail.com. Give her the show number, have her call up. We'd love to talk to her. But I don't know, man. Like, it's a great alternative, but that's not what she said. So it'd be completely different if that's what she said. If she says, but if you don't, I'll show you how, or something like that. Even if it was a sales pitch, it's different. Like, that's not what she's saying. It just sounds extremely biased, extremely arrogant, and bougie as a motherfucker, for real. I mean, to keep it real.
But what standards are acceptable for a sister to have then?
I kind of feel like, I think it depends on the individual. Like, certain, like, you meet people, sometimes you ain't even got to give yourself up to be in a compromising situation, you know what I'm saying? Versus you might meet somebody and you might end up clicking with them, but it takes a longer time. But I think for a standard, but
let me put it to you this way. Your daughter comes to you and asks you, what should she expect of a man? What's your response?
My response would be a man of high moral character, a righteous, self-aware, strong-minded, employed individual.
In that order, huh?
I mean, not necessarily in the order. I mean, responsible. I mean, it's certain qualities. I forgot what show it was. Yo, we did a while ago, and somebody had asked me what I let my daughter date to do like me. And I mean, for the most part, yeah. Like I feel like for the most part, like my good definitely always my bad. Like 90-10.
Right.
In my opinion.
You're talking about
a
dude like you today. Like a dude like
today.
You maybe 10 years ago.
Because
today, Rome is the responsible individual handling his business and doing what he got. You don't want your daughter to be with a guy for 10 years. You figure that out, do you?
No, not at all. But, I mean, that's life, though. You know what I'm saying? That's life. Like that. It happens
right.
Sometimes.
Well, what that young lady is saying is, I don't want to waste that time.
See, that's society
say,
made. Like
we've all
everything's
said,
fast, everything's ready
we
made.
We ain't gonna do that. We end up doing. Let's keep it a stack with that. You know, however, you know, if your standards start at 750 or whatever she said, 700, and she meets a great guy with a 600 credit score. I really don't think it will be that absolute because we all change, like you said, given on circumstances. However, it's got to be a basement to it. You feel me? Like I don't, you know, I want my daughter to find somebody that's going to work hard, that can sustain them in times of a pinch. And I want my daughters to work, you know, to be able to do to contribute if that's what they want to do as far as working. However, I want somebody that's responsible, somebody that will unequivocally love them. You know, I don't want somebody that they got to nurture along for a decade until he finally wakes up and sees the light. I just don't. You know, so if my daughter said, well, you know, I don't want nobody with a credit score below so-and-so, my first inclination, I'm not going to lie, like you're saying. But in the back of my mind, I'm going to be thinking, I don't want you to have nobody with a fucked up credit score either.
Yeah, but see, the thing with that is, it's kind of like, I got a perfect credit score. I could be anything. You know what I mean? Your credit score don't determine the individual you are. It just means you got good credit. It just means you got good credit. So it just sounds like some shallow ass shit. You know, it just sounds like some shallow ass shit. That doesn't determine. So if my credit score was 500 and I met Shorty and she was all on me, you know what I'm saying? Like she gonna be all on me before she found it. She's not coming up to dudes and be like, hey, my name's Janet. What's your credit score? That's not happening. Like it's not happening. It's not real, man. Like I said, it's not real. I don't believe it.
I don't know, bro. Knowing my daughters, if that was part of their standard, you gonna hear that immediately.
Daughters. Those are your daughters. But all I'm saying is that it's an exception to every rule.
Facts.
In most cases. You know what I'm saying? In most cases, it's an exception to every rule. This is just another one. Like, it's no way. I could be. You can't tell me she's not going to meet her soulmate, and he might have a 550 credit beacon score, and she's going to tell him that she's not going to date him, or he's not going to get the draws. Like, that's not going to happen. You know what I'm saying? It's not realistic.
It's no different than a chick turning you down because you don't drive a certain car or because you live at your mama house. If you want to, you know, there are some situations where, yeah, you will get turned down for something that you don't feel is worthy of you being turned down, but you will get turned down. You know, so it will happen. You know, I get you. You know, it's not going to happen like in every case, and it probably won't even happen in most cases under those circumstances, but I could see that happening. You know, and I'm looking at Deeper Than Ocean's situation, and she said it's helpful she don't think finding a good partner should have anything to do with money,
facts,
ambition, ability, noty money. I'm not sure what that meant. However, I think that I don't think it's like I said. I don't think it's necessarily the money aspect. I think it's and once again, I didn't get a chance to read the article. So, but I think it's more the responsibility aspect. And maybe she went about saying that in a fucked up way, you know, because she could have easily said, "I won't date a broke dude." But I think she's looking a little further as far as not being broke.
I know responsible crackheads. You know what I'm saying? So that don't mean nothing. You know what I'm saying? Like, come on, man.
Do you?
Like. Yeah, facts.
I don't think I've ever met her. I'm sorry, bro. I don't think I've ever met a responsible crackhead.
I've met
people that smoke crack that aren't as bad as crackheads, but responsible? No, I can't say I have. Hey, but we do got
to go to work.
And I want to take this. I know this a queen right here, so hold on one second. We're going to get to 9253. And for whatever reason, man, like Facebook is really just dumping on me today because I can't read the comments in the event. But anyway, let me get to 9253. What's good, Queen?
Hello, sir. What's going on, King?
Much. How you doing?
What?
I'm doing good. Let me get y'all speaker. I was listening, guys, on the speaker. My view is I don't know about a credit score of 600, but I would want somebody to have some kind of decent credit. Because if you got bills and we get married, they're garnishing my check and yours. So you're coming with that, you know. So if you have them, yes, if you don't know, I'll be happy to show you. But then you got some people that don't want to learn how to be responsible. So it's kind of like a catch-22 with that. So, I mean, we got to have standards. We all have standards, male or female. We have to have some standards. Or we like, everyone has one. We're not going to say, okay, I like them all black and ugly or orange and purple and ugly or whatever. You know, we have a specific preference, you know. So you can't knock a person for their preference. I mean, it's just what all they
right,
are. And go ahead.
All right, so let me ask you this. What do you think is called What do you think is causing, like, the big divide, or, like, why does it seem like there's so much friction between the black male and the black woman nowadays?
Because the main friction is we want to blame each other for problems that was caused by white supremacy. So, you know, we want to blame the man because he's not strong and he's not protecting us. But you don't remember that during slavery times when they tried to protect us, they were castrated, raped in front of their women, and that they'll come get your woman and sleep with your woman. You know, y'all know the history. So they didn't feel they were needed. So that's sort of like a mental illness. That goes from generation to generation. So like Dude said earlier, that's like a book-like mentality. You know, so we play the blame game. Oh, he's not doing this or we not doing that. How about we just get a common ground and try to get it together? And if you're both willing to work, because one person can't take the full load. You know, if I know you got issues with your credit or whatever, okay, boo, let me help you do this. You know, let me help you try to take. But if you don't want to do that and you want to still spend money and you want to party like you don't have bills, then I'm not the one for you, you know.
Right, you kind of slowing me up. You feel what I'm saying?
In
that sense, I feel as though at this point in time, right now, we have to be more lenient with each other. You feel me?
Right.
Because obviously, we already know that white supremacy is got the whole boot in our ass right now, and they don't have no picks.
Yeah.
Children, grandmothers, men and women. You feel what I'm saying? Nobody, all of us are basically being victimized at this point in time. So I don't see why we spend most of our times going back and forth with each other over frivolous things, something that's not even tangible, something that's not even hindering us from moving forward. But us not complying with each other is really the hindrance right there, and that's basically why we're having this whole conversation now. And I totally agree with you. And what we're trying to figure out is how do we get other people on board to see the things from this lens, and the ones that don't see it, should we just disregard them?
That's a good question, because it's hard. Sometimes it's hard to change the minds of people, you know, because they've been hurt by a relationship. They think all men ain't no good, you know. And the same thing with brothers. If they get hurt, and that's times 10 with a brother, because, you know, a brother, they get their feelings hurt more easier than women, believe it or not. So they like, oh, no, I'm going to be the player, you know. So it's hard. It's hard. I don't know. I really don't. That's a good question. We just got to keep talking and encouraging them. Some people will change their mindset. The more conscious they get, you know, they can change their mind, but they got to be open to it. If you're not open to it and you're a closed-minded fool, then you're not going to change. You're not going to grow.
Yeah. I like the fact that you said once you become more conscious and aware, once I really start finding out about my inner self and being more conscious, I'm like, how can I gravitate towards somebody that looks just like me? Being the female specimen, like, that makes absolutely no sense. I couldn't imagine myself dating outside my race. They would, if you see me with a white girl, 9 times out of 10 they kidnap me. When you see me blinking real fast, they got me. I'm like, I'm mumbling, they got me, brother, they got me. I don't know Becky, I don't know her, they got me. You
I don't. I dated one white guy, and like I said on the Facebook, it was during the time a friend, she was going through that, and she tried to swindle me into it, and I was still looking for him to say nigga, you know, around me. I never was comfortable with him being around him. And then when he started talking about black men, I was like, hold up, player, you know,
right. That was the white. That's the white supremacist test right there. He wanted to see how far he could go. First, he wanted to bash the women. Bash the men. Then he gonna see if you're gonna bash along with him. Like, okay, yeah, I got me one right here. That's the white supremacist test. Once you cut him off, you're like, oh, let me move on, get out of there.
Right.
You feel me? I mean, that's how I feel. So that's how a lot of them is, because, like Dr. Francis Boston once said, for real, like white supremacists and suspected white supremacists, they can have sex with black people, but once they get out of that bed, it's back to business. It's back to building with their people. You feel what I'm saying? We feel as though. We feel as though once we have sex with a white person for real, we're just indoctrinated into their world. Like, we're accepted now. You feel what I'm saying? Like, it's funny because it's a movie, but we all see Undercover Brother, right? See Undercover Brother, when he started dating the white girl, he lost the afro, he was putting mayonnaise on everything. He was indoctrinated into the white world. Trained in the Cadillac, had on duck suits and all. He thought he was white. Like, and it's funny because that's how a lot of black people get when they lay down with white people. But white people never do that. They always go back to building with their own. No, I'm sorry.
I do think that, at least from my standpoint, and I'll give you an example. I think let me backtrack a little bit as far as how we can change that. I think that men have to be willing to step to their boys, and women have to be willing to step to their girls. And I give you an example. I was cool with a dude. Like, this was my homeboy, you know, and he lived with a woman. He had a baby mama, and he didn't have to work at all. His woman, you know, was making bread. You know, he did work, don't get me wrong, you know, but he didn't have to. She would take care of things, and she didn't care. You know, but when she would go to work, he would bring his baby mama and his baby over to their house and she would spend almost a whole day. And it got to the point where I had to tell him, you know, I felt uncomfortable. It was wrong. Like, dude, I'm not getting in your business, and you cheating is you cheating, but you violating your house. That's just not cool, bruh. And we ain't cool anymore. Because I just can't, you know, I'm not trying to dictate your life, bro, and I'm not trying to say that, you know, every man is going to be infallible and every man is going to be faithful. But there's just, you know, you cross the line, and at some point somebody got to say something. And if I'm your boy and you clearly violating, and you are, I got to speak to it. And
well,
I don't
some people can't handle
enough,
the truth,
you know. Well, you know what, and that's true.
It.
And we ain't
say they don't want to talk to you no more, and that's why I only got 2 girlfriends, because if I speak my mind, you mad at me, and I'm telling you what's right, because I'm not going to tell you, for example, you to lay up with married men, and think you're supposed to have some integrity or they don't treat me right. You act like a trick, you get treated like a trick, plain and simple. That's just the dozens, you know, that you got to deal with, the hands you're going to deal with. Now, if you want to act like a lady, you got to come correct, not showing booty shots on Facebook, showing your behind and thinking a man's supposed to respect you. So,
yeah, that's not going to happen. Hey, Queen, and I'm not cutting anybody off, but we got another caller. I'm going to keep you on the line, though. But I want to bring 2137 into the mix, if y'all don't mind.
Okay.
What's good, fam?
Hey, what's good, baby? Same old man. It's your boy Tone.
Not much, man.
Peace.
Good, Tone. What is up, brother?
Same old man. You know me, man. I'm blessed. I'm feeling good. Shit, I woke up this morning, so I'm real good. You know what I'm saying?
Thanks. Man, it sounds like you in a bank with dirt bike right now, my brother. I hear the wind all in the phone, my guy.
My bad, bro. I'm in El Paso, man. Like, I just got from under a truck, bro. It's the wind blowing. Let me get behind this truck. Hold on.
No doubt, brother. No doubt.
And you know what? Trying to sound better now?
Yeah.
A little bit. But before you even say anything, Tone, I want to say that you and your queen are inspiring. And I'm going to keep that a stack. And I don't think that's the first time I've told you that. But the love is palpable. Like the y'all friends, and you can tell. And I think
that's my best friend.
That
man.
Right
my,
there,
you
need to show more of that to encourage other people to give them hope in having that. My bad. Go ahead.
All right. Well, the thing is, like, I appreciate that. You know what I'm saying? But the thing is, like, aside from her, she is my best friend. She held me down for the past 14 years through every fuck-up I done made and every great decision I done made, you know what I'm saying? Every accomplishment I done made and every failure I done endured. She done held me down, whether we were together or not. But the thing is, it's one of the starting solutions we should have in the black community. We need to start identifying with each other. You know what I'm saying? For example, I posted a video before. It was of this white lady who was a teacher. And she hit with real shit. She said, the thing is, the majority of teachers in the elementary schools is white women, right?
Right.
So when a white boy comes in, she identifies with him. She identifies with her. He sees his mother in him, in her. She sees her son in him. So when he's out doing his thing, getting all crazy in class, not paying attention, they chop it up as boys will be boys. They chop it up as he's just a kid. Yet they don't identify with a black kid. So when he do it out the gate, he's acting out. Maybe something's wrong in the home. Because of the fact that she don't see in him like she see what she see in the white boy. But that's the thing why they get along and why they can keep each other back so hard. Because please believe, if I walk in the gap right now and I get into it with a white lady, every white dude in there gonna jump up. Yet,
right. We
in the projects and we at the liquor store and a white dude, who ain't even a cop, to start him and his brother up, we pull out our phone. We ain't gonna go to his rescue. Mm-hmm. Like, what you doing? Hey, chill out. It ain't going down like this. We pull out our phones and we start screaming and hollering. You got me fucked up. I'm gonna die about mine. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
That's the thing, though. The mentality to begin all the solutions. Like, we can talk about the solutions all day, but we really have to start identifying with each other. Regardless, man, me and you, Joseph, if me and you get into it yesterday, but I see you where you finna get jammed up right now. Regardless of what we went through, at the end of the day, it's still me and you. Against everybody that's trying to fuck you up. Fuck us up. You see what I'm saying?
Yep.
Hispanic dudes,
now,
they
I will say one thing, though. To that end, like, when you from Detroit, and let's say, and I done seen it, you know, you see somebody else, and I don't care where it is, you know, we could be, and I've been in Atlanta, and I've seen people from Detroit. And when you say you from Detroit, and if you got a problem, we going to handle that problem down there.
Mm-hmm.
Well, how we deal with each other when we get back home, maybe a whole different scenario. But once we step out that city and you say, what up, though? I already know, bruh. We riding together whether we riding together. So I feel you 100%.
And I do this shit like, I'm not going to lie, at work, I'm in the Army. I have been labeled a racist so many times because I see this motherfucking male lieutenant chewing out this female fucking soldier. And she just a private. She 20 years old. This motherfucker 35 years old. He yelling, fussing, and cussing at her and all that shit. And everybody watching. I'm like, hey, first off, sir, that's disrespectful and extremely unprofessional. Lower your tone when you talk to these soldiers. At all times, I'll be professional. That's in y'all creed. It's like it's in our NCO creed. So how about you back the fuck up? And I don't care what you do to me, but you're going to be professional with this soldier like you is with everybody else. And they say, Son Harris, you always fucking sticking up for the black soldiers. And I say, you know what? You're right, because ain't nobody else doing it. You got one soldier. Right?
You got a lot of feedback in your phone. I don't know what that noise is, Tone, but you got a lot of.
That's not me. I hear it too. Like, while I'm talking, I'm here.
That's not
like
you.
Somebody, another conversation.
Sound like a TV,
hey, bro. I hear it. Well, I'm outside. I ain't got it.
Well, we about to fix that.
Sound like a TV.
We about to find
or
out. No, go.
It did. All
right.
But like I'm saying though, like I'm gonna take up for mine. I don't give a fuck if it's in the streets or when I'm in uniform. Because at the end of the day, yeah, I'm an American soldier. And every black person I see is an American citizen that I got to motherfucking protect. So you got me fucked up if you think I'm finna favor one over the other. And you got me fucked up if you think I'm not finna favor my black people. Because y'all white folks treated me the same way when I was a pride. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. I feel that.
But
I feel that 100%.
Thing,
we, I feel you. I like that at work too.
The minute we start identifying with each other, the same way white folks identify with them, I mean, I'm just saying that sounds like the beginning of unity to me. You know what I'm saying?
I agree with that, man. Like, that's actually, I think I found the source. And Crystal, I think that was you.
I'm
sorry,
TV.
Queen.
I don't have no TV on. I don't have no TV on.
I don't know what it is. I'd have muted everybody except for Tom and me. When I muted you, it went away. I'm just
you
saying.
Got an Obama phone.
I promise I don't have a TV on.
Is it an Obama phone though? If it's an Obama phone, you
no,
tap.
No, it's Sprint. It's a Sprint.
That's close. No, I'm just messing with you.
But like,
I got a fan on. That's what I got on. But
that's what it is.
I
that's what it is.
A TV. Y'all said it was a TV too. Okay.
No, I didn't. I just knew it was a noise. But that's the fan because I have to turn mine off when I'm on the show, and that's why I lose like 2 pounds every week.
But
yeah,
I mean,
think
like,
I'm joking, man.
That's just my thought about it. Like, the minute we start identifying with each other more, we start seeing ourselves and other black brothers. Queens start seeing themselves and other queens. You know what I'm saying? I see my mother, my sister, my daughter in another in a female. I see my brother, my uncle, my grandfather in another dude. It's gonna make it so much easier to stand beside him because of the fact that I identify with him. I don't give a damn if you Crip, Blood, Folk, Damu, if you're a Muslim, if you're a Christian, if you're an atheist, if you're a hotel brother. I don't care. At the end of the day, it's me and you finna get shot by these cops, so we finna go down together, and we finna fight, knock every motherfucker we can out together. You know what I'm saying?
All right, so let me ask you this: How do you feel that we, as far as it's put that type of idealistic thought process and instincts into our brothers and sisters, as far as though when it comes to relations?
When it comes to relations, like real shit, man.
Yeah, because we're having a divide right now between genders.
We are, because of the fact that we've been put in so many situations. We've been taken out of our homes. Female have been, I ain't trying to step on no toes. Female have been over-empowered. I get it. You know what I'm saying? A woman is supposed to be able to do, a woman is supposed to be able to do everything a man could do. Because when I'm going off to work, or if I'm going on a deployment and I go to war, or if I die, goddammit, that woman should know exactly my morals and my ethics in life and should be able to instill that in my child as if I was still there. You see what I'm saying? But they also, the most important thing about a woman is the fact that they can do what we can't do. When my son fuck up, I'm going to fuck his world up. And he's going to run to mama. And mama going to break it down to him. Baby, look, I'm sorry you had to feel that, but you fucked up. Your daddy might not be able to voice it to you, but he loves you. And he's trying to put an end to that shit right now before it gets out of hand. Now, he's so mad right now, he can't sit here and talk to you like I can, but you my baby, I love you, and I'm sorry you had to feel that pain, but you needed it because you asked for it. Meanwhile, I'm in the kitchen brooding like this nigga done fucked up. What the fuck I done did to give him the impression that this shit is okay? I'm so mad at him and myself like I might have fucked up. My wife can take it up, but pick up the slack behind me and let my child know on a more compassionate level. Women are more compassionate than men. Like, men straight up, like, think about it. Why you think me and you can get to a fight right now? And no matter how cool we act, I'm going to still hold on to this shit. Female, get into it. Man, you know how many times the next fucking day, girl, yes, I know that was some bullshit, but you know, anyway, back to this mark-ass nigga, Deshaun. You know what I'm saying?
That's a fact. That's a fact.
I don't know. I think
men hold on to it more so. I mean, I think women hold on to it more so than men.
Like, I love my little brother, but I'm still mad at him for fucking up my PlayStation.
Well, that's different, bro. You know,
that's
like,
crossing the line.
But like I'm saying, though, like, men have roles, gender-specific roles. Women have gender-specific roles, but at the same time, women can do what men can do and more because of the fact, at the end of the day, if something happened to me, if I'm protecting my family and I get taken out the game, I have no fucking doubt that my wife will make sure that my son grows up knowing exactly how I would want him to understand things, knowing exactly how I want him to be raised, knowing exactly what I want him to see is important in life, to his life and to those lives around him, knowing that I want him to grow up to be a protector of my motherfucking queens, because, goddammit, if I'm going to die about mine, my son will grow up dying about his, for real. And I know my wife will instill that in him. I will never say that a woman can't do everything a man can do, because at the end of the day, when shit hit the fan, a woman is going to have to do that sometimes. But women are important because they can do what we can't do. Like, I can't sit up on a hospital bed and push a baby out of my penis. You got me fucked up.
Like,
and my wife is pregnant right now. She a lot stronger than me, because I'd have been like, hey, y'all gotta guess too. Y'all gotta
guess.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. But like I say, I respect her for her stuff, because me, y'all better put this little motherfucker in a test tube. I'm not finna sit here and then do all this shit. Hell no. For real. For real. But and the thing, that's the thing. Like, and when my child is born, like, my wife carried my seed in her. You see what I'm saying? She carried my seed in her. So regardless on how hard I am, my wife will always be able to find a compassionate side to explain to my child, like, you can't see it through his anger right now, but he's doing the best thing for you that you deserve, because you're really heading down that line. You know what I'm saying? So
that's what it's supposed to be. That's what it's supposed to be. That's a natural order of it.
Oh, yeah.
And
going
you know
back
what
I was saying earlier, like, I identify so well with my wife because her characteristics in loving and taking care of her family and doing what she got to do and sacrificing what she got to, the way my mother did growing up, while I was growing up, the way my sister, like, my sister stopped chilling because my mom worked two jobs. So it was just me and my sister at the house. So until I got to a certain age, my mama found it all right to stop working two jobs. My sister was my mama, too. You know what I'm saying? And
right.
Because my daddy died if I was born. So it ain't like, and my mom's first husband was a mark-ass bitch. Like, he used to smack me around because the wind blew. You know what I'm saying? But my sister was the one that was like, man, you got to be stronger than this. You can't see this shit and take all this pain and hold it and become that man. Like, your daddy was a way different man from him. I love your daddy like he was my daddy. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, my sister put my daddy's mentality in my head. You see what I'm saying?
Wow.
Yeah.
So it's like.
That's deep.
Yeah,
man, women
definitely
are the most amazing computers in the world, because regardless of how, look, women will remember everything like an elephant, brother. I'm telling you, if you treat them amazing, shit, you always gonna know she remember that shit. But the day you fuck up, please believe you're gonna be wondering for the rest of your life. Just wait on them grits to give you while I'm sleeping.
And you better have that. If you come up with an answer, and you better have that answer for the next 20 years, because I might come back and ask you the same question. And if you come up with a different answer, you getting God.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Why y'all do
remember
that? But why do y'all do that?
We just like you said, we have a computer mind. So if you telling me this, I'm taking it as the truth. That's how some of y'all get caught up. Y'all if y'all gonna lie to the end. Y'all forget.
Bro,
somebody can tell you 2 weeks later,
nope,
come back and ask the same thing, you'd be like,
it's simpler than that, man. The answer is simple. It's because some idiot invented the TV. So these women see that somebody, some other fucking idiot, do some dumb shit on TV. You know what? I remember when Joseph did that. Matter of fact, let me bring this shit back up. Hey, Joseph, so when you went out that weekend with your friends, remember, on your birthday, and you said you was staying at Josh's house, and he was like, yeah, we got back at 11. Oh, I thought you said y'all got back to Josh out at 12. So where the fuck was your motherfucker's antennas at 11? You know what I'm saying? They're going to remember every
detail of
the
fact
shit.
That you gotta, the fact that you got to do that inherently is the problem. Like,
they
wired that you should not, you know.
Like, why
can
we just let shit go?
Do that? And if you feel to the point where, if you with somebody and you feel to the point where you got to keep asking them the same question about their whereabouts, their whereabouts is really not the problem. It's the fact that you got to ask them that. You don't trust them.
Might be
just
a memory, like you said. It might be a memory that popped up because my parents do it. My mother might come up and talk about something that happened 50 years ago because she saw something on TV. Just like you said, exactly. That's why I was like,
And you might
be like,
look, I'm 30. I'm 30, bro, and my mama be bringing up shit like from when I was five. I'm like, mama, you do realize there was a time in my life where there was nothing but weed. I don't remember that time. I don't remember anything before that. What you mean?
Because it's all emotion. It's all emotion. It's all emotional ties for them. It's no.
We're emotional by nature. We're women. Women are emotional
right.
by nature. That's what we are. You know, like
no doubt.
They get offended about it. But
no doubt about that. There's no doubt about that.
Well,
y'all definitely emotional. I just say I use a tad bit more logic and
well,
within the thinking. I got an argument with my girl off of how something I said made her feel, not what I said, but how it made her feel.
Mm-hmm.
That's not how I said it. So we having two totally different conversations at the same time. Like, yo, you mad about something that I said made you feel, but I was only saying it in this context. You know what I'm saying? All I said was this. But then you got one that's mad, one that's hurt, and another one who's sitting there looking like, what the fuck did I say? You know what I'm saying? Versus what I might say is something logical, and she received what I said and processed it emotionally.
Well, men are wired.
And you know
like,
what? That's a crucial element right
mm-hmm.
there. It's because a lot of times we feel like we can impose our way to love on people, and that's just
that's
not
true.
How it works. People receive love differently. And for you to be
mm-hmm.
successful in a relationship, you got to learn your partner and how they receive love. You know, now are you going to change your whole foundation? No. However, you can change the living room. You can add on an attic. You know, you can make changes as to accommodate the best way your partner will receive your love. You know, sometimes, you know, and it may get to a point where you feel like, you know what, I'm just incapable of giving you the type of love that you require. But in most instances, you know, at least from my experience, if you make a couple of changes and maybe the way you deliver certain conversations, it goes a long
mm-hmm.
way. You know your partner after a certain while, and you know that little tick they get with the left eye means something.
Oh,
you know,
man.
When y'all having a conversation, you know, move on with that. You got to, instead of just saying stop with your eye. You know, how about saying, you know, thinking to yourself, well, he does this with his eye every time I do this. You know, how about I'm not changing what I'm saying, I'm changing how I'm saying it, and what you'll realize is the eye stopped ticking. You know, and to go to Tone's point, you know, I think that especially men are hesitant to learn in a lot of cases when they, you know, especially when they got a good woman. They are hesitant to learn her quote-unquote role. There's nothing wrong with your woman teaching you how to cook. There's nothing wrong with your woman saying, you know what, you wash clothes okay. I like the way you wash clothes, and in a pinch, that's cool. But this is the way you're supposed to wash clothes. You know, now, there may be a case where it's vice versa. You know, because a lot of brothers, they're raised by their mama.
Vice versa now. Mm-hmm.
Right. And a woman has to be able to understand, you know what, I can cook a turkey, but goddamn, he can put his foot in that turkey. How can I get that turkey that way? Instead of feeling intimidated that they are better at a quote-unquote role, learn the role. That way, just like Tone said, when they out of the picture for whatever reason, you off on business or you go visit somebody or you just go hang out with your boys, they don't have to wait for you to do that particular thing. They may not have to do it all the time, but when they need to do it, they can.
Right.
Hey, what you spoke on earlier, man, you hit three hard topics though. Like one, check this out, it's this book, man. My chaplain that's assigned to my unit. When my wife got married, he hit me with this book, and it's called The Five Love Languages. And on some real shit, I suggest y'all check it out, man, because everybody receives love differently, and everybody has a different way that they – like, everybody can see types of love, but it's a certain type of love that certain person is in tune to. You know what I'm saying? Like, some people love gestures. Like rent. Now, you ain't even got to go buy them shit, but just doing, like, acts of love. You know what I'm saying? Like, shit, you know your wife's been having a long-ass day. You notice, but so you go home with a single fucking rose. Or you get out, as soon as you get in the door, before you do anything, you get to your wife like, hey, baby, look, I know you had a long-ass day. Chill out, relax. Let me hit dinner tonight. Just chill out and just decompress for a minute. You know what I'm saying? Like, some women love that more than a fucking, like, diamond, believe it or not, diamond ring. You can get a chick $1,000 and shit every fucking day, and they'll like that. But, I mean, that may not be what they're in tune to as receiving love. Like, some people like more intimacy than receiving gifts. Some people like gifts more than gestures. Some people like just hearing the fact, baby, you are beautiful. Like, no matter what you think about yourself, how you feeling today, you're the most beautiful woman in my fucking life. Believe that. And you don't know that could have took her to fucking Pluto, and she's going to be on fucking cloud nine for the next 3 weeks. You feel what I'm saying? It's just you got to figure out. About, when I say identifying with our people, you have to figure out how everybody around you, especially your mate, your intimate mate, that how they receive love. Another point you hit on, the roles thing. Like, yeah, there are certain roles that's generic to genders, but at the same time, for example, like me, I'm a beast in the kitchen. Like, y'all know, like, you see on everything I post, everything I do is savage, especially when I'm in that kitchen. Because you see, I get big as fuck, fast as hell, because of the fact I know how to work that kitchen. For real. I mean, don't get me wrong. My wife, she feels a certain way when I get too into it, and I go the whole month. And so she'll just straight up be like, baby, like, for real, you make me feel like a horrible wife because of the fact that I know you got a long day at work, and you in the kitchen and cooking for the family, and I'm sitting here like, does he see me as, like, I can't do this? And I tell her, like, nah, like, real shit, when I'm in the kitchen, everything bad that happened to me that day don't mean shit because of the fact that not only am I feeding my family, but I'm fucking getting that work in, because in the kitchen I love to do that shit. You see what I'm saying? So now we got, like, all right, well, she hit me with, all right, on the weekends, you can do your thing, just make sure that steak and asparagus is on the side for me. You know what I'm saying? Like, so the weekends, I take it. But through the week, she makes sure that me, like, I get off work, and I be tired as fuck. And she be like, get the fuck out of my kitchen, go take your shower, lay down, I'll bring your food. And I mean, like, real shit to me, that's like, I get a time to rest. What you mean? Okay, thank you so much. You know what I'm saying? Like, it'll be days where she like, baby, just go in your basement, turn your video game on and veg out. Me and Kansas got shit planned today. Go down there with your dog and play video games and just relax. And like, straight up, out, like, getting chill time is the most amazing thing I could fucking get. You know what I'm saying?
Yo, can you do me a favor for real? I need you to do me a favor.
Yeah, what's up?
Clone her. Clone her for me.
Bro, the thing about that, I would, but you don't want to go through what I went through to get here. Like what me, the storms me and her went through. You know what I'm saying? I'm not gonna lie. Like she told me, like, I know that bullshit you keep saying. I want to focus on, like, in high school when I was saying I want to focus on football. She knew I was fucking trying to. I didn't want to cheat on her, so I would just stop it so I could go fuck cheerleaders. You know what I'm saying? Like, we done went through so much shit. She went in and tried to join the Navy, the Air Force, and we lost a baby. We had fucking people that went through that mistake of allowing other people in our relationship, letting our family dictate how our relationship go. Fucking, like, it's so much shit me and her went through to get here. Like, no shit, man. We went to the factory and built each other. You know what I'm saying? Like, man, if my wife
and y'all
died, I can't get married again, because I refuse to go through that shit again. Anybody, because she is my fucking rib. Like, when I say God tailored her for me, I have never been this happy in my fucking life. I have never been this driven in my life to be fucking amazing. Like, this army shit is amazing. I love this army shit, but because of her, it's more out there. God damn it. She made me want to be the motherfucking president. She made me want to take control of the fucking world and run that shit with an iron fist. You know what I'm saying? Like, she drives
that's
me to
what
drive
a woman, that's what a real woman's supposed to do. You know, you're not supposed to put them down because y'all got enough that y'all face in the world when y'all go out in the world. So you coming home to madness is not helping, and that's what happens why a lot of men step out, because you're being nasty to it instead of encouraging them, like, yeah, we got this, you know, don't worry about that, let me handle this, I got you, or what have you, you know. And that's the problem with most women. They too busy nagging, or why you not doing this, why you not doing that. I'd be happy if you pay a bill. That's a turn on to me. Thank you for paying my phone bill. I love you.
Queen,
but, you know,
Tone.
But,
Yeah, yo.
I hate to cut you off. We only got 15 minutes left. I got two more callers I got to get to.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, go ahead, bro.
I got my headphone in.
I'm going to get back to this truck. Already.
All right.
I appreciate y'all letting me on, man, and hearing what I had to say in my rants and raves. But you know what I'm saying? Y'all stay blessed. Yup. And stay safe and look out for each other because we all we got, baby.
Thank you, man. Appreciate it, man.
Oh, yeah. 17th of December. Carter Lynn going to be in this bitch running shit. You believe that?
I told you. That's Christmas, man. Don't mess up my scheduling, all right? It's Christmas.
Hey, man, you got to think about it, man. For one, she a female, and for two, she a baby. So, you know, they do what they want.
He might not come on the 17th.
But, yeah, y'all
let her come on the
27th. Salute, man. Have a good one, man.
All right. Y'all take it easy.
All right.
All right, so I got, and I'm sorry, 9672. I just realized that actually 4306 been on hold for a minute. So I'm going to get to them right quick, and then I'm going to bring you in. And like I say, we got 14 minutes left, all right? What's good, fam?
When they took it out, it stopped hurting. Hello?
It must got you on speaker. It must got you on speaker.
Give it one more time.
Okay,
hello?
Hello?
Can you guys hear me?
We can.
Yeah, we can hear you.
Can anybody
hear
me?
What's your name? Who's calling?
Me?
Yes. Yes.
Okay, you guys can hear me. Okay. Hi.
Do you have
everybody.
A radio on or
Do
something? Because
you got
an
echo.
Hold on. Is that better? Is this better?
That is. That's much better.
Or no? Okay.
Yeah, that's much better.
I had you on. Okay, I was on speaker, but.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
So,
did everybody speak already or what?
Yeah, it's time to speak right now. We're talking about gender wars, you feel what I'm saying, how we could just make the relationship between black people much stronger and better.
Okay. I'm really late to the conversation, but I did want to bring up one thing to it. I know that there's a lot of feminist movements or whatnot going on, but I don't know how you guys feel about it. I personally feel like it's kind of going against black people in general because the number one thing that they've done to us to oppress us is bring the black man all the way down. And I think it's our job as females to bring up the black man versus having a war with them and trying to have a higher position and all that. Even though women do get high positions, they should be using that to uplift the black male because the black male is the one that, we're under the black male's house if you're a black woman, unless you decide to be single, but the ultimate goal in life is to have a family, and you would want the head of your house to be stronger. I would, or at least I would.
I totally agree.
You still got the echo. I think that's you, AJ.
I don't see how it was me. It never been me before.
I don't know. My house is really hollow right now. It could be my house.
But what I do, we're not gonna worry about it. We got about 10 minutes left. We'll deal with it.
So I think we can all kind of agree with that.
Go ahead, Ron.
No, what's the queen name? What's the queen name?
I'm sorry. What was that? Get him away.
What was your name?
Samantha.
Samantha. All right.
Yeah.
Do you mind telling us what state you live in?
Telling us what state you live in.
Washington.
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 Yeah.
Okay. All right. All right. Cool.
Okay, all right.
All right.
Cool.
No, I was curious.
Seattle, Washington. But yeah. Also, I don't know. I don't know how strong my opinion could be because I've been married 9 years. So. Well, technically, I've been married 5 years, but I've been with him 9 years, so.
Well, that makes your opinion very strong because you actually have years, mileage, and a foundation to support your claims of what you're saying. So it makes your opinion
very
valid.
Yeah, I mean, I went through, you know, my period where I was on that independent woman thing, and I can't have no man tell me what to do or none of that. And then it came to a point where I was also being more controlling. So I have gone through that, but it's definitely your family ain't strong, your house ain't strong, nothing is strong if your man ain't strong. And as a woman. I mean, a woman is a man's glory, so it's up to a woman to make that man feel like somebody, because a woman can either break a man or build him up. So, and all throughout history, you know, either a downfall of a man has been a woman, or their greatness, they've had, you know, a good woman on their side. So I think it really, I really think it means a lot, and I think it's very important that we... That's why I can't deal with women that, I'm sorry, Adele, women that date black men. It's a slap in the face to your culture, I think. Your whole race is a slap in the face.
Let me ask you this. What, and like I said, we only got a couple minutes left, but real quick, if you can, what was the turning point for you? What changed to give you that wisdom?
Well, it's just, I think I saw it happen to another man where, like, he just, like, his woman was calling him a bitch and just treated him like, you know, like he was a kid or something. And I didn't want to do that to my man. And I just realized on certain things that, I think just seeing other people do it, like realize that I need to change and made me realize what I was doing. It's just, but
okay. I salute that. And I'm pretty
so,
sure
I mean,
that
I did go through
that
for a while.
That.
I'm still working on it. So don't.
Yeah. So would you say that the relationship between a black woman and a black man, as far as building a beautiful household, is like a team effort, basically?
Most definitely.
Both the man and the woman should know their positions and be the best person at that position.
See, that's the thing. Women don't like having a man have a higher position. Yes, it's a teamwork, and you need both people to paddle the boat, I guess, to get across the lake. But at the same time, the man is stronger, and your man is supposed to protect you. So if you empower that man with everything and make him feel like King Kong, he can go out in the world and be King Kong. That's how I feel.
Right.
If you can make him feel like that at home, he can go out in the world and feel like that. And I could see a big difference too, even in my husband. So
it means everything. It really does. But Queen, I want to thank you so much for calling in. I want to get to this next caller right quick. And please don't forget about us. Tune in on Thursdays from 7 to 9 Eastern Standard Time.
Okay, I just need to learn my times better. I'm on West Coast time and everybody else is on East Coast time, so I don't. But yeah,
are you on Facebook?
Yeah.
Look up My Skin Is My Sin. And,
she's in the group already.
Oh, is she? All right, bet. Join the event. And that way, it'll automatically give you a notification once I post it.
My skin is my... Say that again?
My skin is my sin.
Okay. All right. Well, shalom,
and
everybody.
Salute to you and your family.
Salute.
All right.
Thank you so much. Man, I am.
All right, thank you, Shalom.
Oops, I'm sorry. I did not mean to cut you off. I thought you were done. I truly apologize. I think it was. I'm giving us an echo. I really didn't mean to do that, man. I didn't. I'm sorry. I really feel bad. And shout out to DC Kemet in the chat room. And, bruh, I'm telling you, man, it's hot as hell over here, and I can't turn the fan on or it's going to sound like it was with Crystal. Woo! Your boy is over here sweating buckets. So I'm going to get 9672 right quick, and I'm going to mute myself and go get me some water. So, I got to, bro. I'm dying, man. I can't afford to lose. No, okay, I could afford to lose a couple pounds, but not this way. You know, I want to actually work on it.
Oh,
what's good, Queen?
Oh, yeah. How you doing? How you doing? Hello, everybody. Kiliana.
Hey,
boo boo. Hey, Cuzzo. Hey, everybody.
Hey, Cuzzo. How are you?
I'm doing well. How about yourself, King?
I'm good. I'm glad. I'm good now. You called up, man.
Oh, here you go. Running that Willy Bobo on me.
So,
what's good?
So, I mean, the title of the show today is Gender Wars. That's what's popping off right here.
It shouldn't be a war. It shouldn't be a war between the men and the women in the melanated community. But we're dealing with these effects of slavery because they did that to us on purpose, the division that they created amongst the family structure. Because they know if we had the family structure down pat, they could not stop us. And that's why we're dealing with these wars, gender wars.
That's
also, women and men. Women, okay, yeah, we're emotional. And we expect men to understand how we feel. And we expect men to know what we want. But motherfucking communication is key, okay? And if you, like they say, closed mouth don't get fed. You can't expect him to, first of all, I'm not, no offense to the kings, but you guys, y'all guys don't think about the bigger picture. Y'all focus on one thing and stay on that thing till it's done, then move on to the next step. Women, we think about the bigger picture. So we're always multitasking, always trying to, you know, look for things and how to make things better for a future event, things like that. That's just the way we're built. We don't think the same, but we can't expect men to understand how we think, you know? And that's a problem we have with women. We're always arguing and fighting with the man because we expect him to understand how we feel and we expect him to know how we think, but it don't work like that. We're not wired the same. You know?
Finally.
So.
Finally.
I agree with it not working
finally.
The same, but as far as looking at the bigger picture, I kind of disagree, and I'm going to tell you why. Like when you have a child, a woman appreciates that experience immediately, and she appreciates the moments in the child's life throughout their life way more than we do. When a man has a child, it's at least in my case, you know, when my daughters were born, I was thinking about prom. I'm thinking 30 years down the road. I'm thinking about them getting married. And a woman is so much more in tune with appreciating the moment, and the man is more in tune with the goal, the destination, as far as how do I raise them, how do I take care of them, how do I plan for their future, how do I plan for them to have kids and be successful.
Right. Now, when I say the bigger picture, when I say women are always thinking about the bigger picture, there's levels of bigger pictures that I'm talking about. It's not, you know, just one big-ass picture and that's that. There's levels. There's the bigger picture for the week. There's the bigger picture for the month. There's the bigger picture for the year. You know what I'm saying? And then, like you said, you know, you're thinking about prom. You're thinking about down the line bigger picture when she's a woman.
Right.
And you want her, you know, to understand how a man is supposed to treat her, and you want her to understand how she's supposed to be, you know, appreciated and treated as a princess coming into her queenhood. You know what I mean? And that also gives you also got to provide the example of how a man is supposed to treat her, so she won't settle for less than what her father treated her. Like Valentine's Day, my brother, who I'm very proud of the king he became, he has nothing but women in his life, me, my mother, his wife, his daughters, you know what I'm saying? So he always gives us all Valentine's Day gifts, you know? And each gift is different, and each gift means something special to him and how he sees the women or each woman in his life. You know what I mean? And if your daughter grows up seeing that daddy shows her love and, you know, gives her flowers and, you know, like how to, you know, allow or, you know, let a man come into her space. You know, it's up to the fathers. Some fathers, you know, sometimes fathers don't do the best they can because it's not their fault. They don't know any better. you know. It's up to the individual to want to do better, you know. They grew up in a dysfunctional household, so all they know is dysfunction. I'm not talking about you personally. I'm just saying a general statement, you know. So mm-hmm. that dysfunction that they grew up with, they have nothing but dysfunctional, actions and nothing but dysfunctional thought patterns. So they provide their children with that same dysfunction that they grew up in. And it's a lot to do with the childhood and the hurt that they're, you know, dealing with and all that, but we ain't going to get all psychological right now, you know. But my point was for saying is we got to understand each other. We got to, the understanding has to be there in order for it to work. You have to understand, you know, how he sees things, and the same for the man. He has to understand how she sees things. And y'all may not agree, but y'all could compromise to come to a, you know, meeting point, a common ground, just to make it work for the sake of the children, if there is children in a picture. You know?
That's true.
So, my,
you know,
my,
and
you
one
know,
thing that I did was, I'm sorry, go ahead.
No, go ahead. Go ahead. Finish what you were saying.
Well, one thing, like early on, I realized, like first off, I was an extreme asshole back in the day. And I did not want my daughters to have an extreme asshole in their life. So
right.
I may not have curtailed my actions generally,
mm-hmm.
but I curtailed what they saw.
Right.
Like they, you know, I refused to allow them to just meet random skirts. You know, that wasn't going to happen.
Right.
You know,
right.
they have, outside of their mother, it didn't work out, but I was always respectful of her, always gave her props, you know, even when she didn't know it, you know. And Christmas time, you know, they called me, you know, Daddy, well, what you want for Christmas? What you get your mama? You know, what I didn't realize, quite honestly, was that she was doing the same thing. You know, because
okay.
We was never one to be like, you know, all up in each other's house, you know. I don't care what you're doing a great job. You are a great mother. And I made it a point to be her cheerleader as they grew older. Not my daughters. I'm always their biggest fan. But I made it a point to be my ex's cheerleader. You're doing a great job. Out the blue. I appreciate what you're doing. You know, because I needed her to know that I'm acknowledging the greatness that we have brought into this world and the greatness of the job that you are doing. Because we all need to hear some positive things, even if it's from something, you know, we didn't work out, don't mean that we don't have a common goal in making sure that ours walk the path of greatness and know where they come from is good stock. And then we can get over not being together. That's not a hindrance to being good parents together. You know, what I find interesting, though, is that I had problems over the years with women because I didn't hate my ex. Because I could call her up and have a conversation about our kids, and it wasn't like I would hide nothing to be calling her, you know, in the closet, you know. No, I wasn't doing that. You know, I could call you, you sitting right there. We could have a conversation just straight up about my kids. However, I'm not calling you, oh, I hate you, blah, 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 blah. You know, this is what I think, you know, what you think, blah, blah, blah. Okay, that's cool. All right, I agree, I disagree, whatever the case. They had a problem with that. Like, why are you mad that I'm not mad at her?
Right.
Because
they mad. That's the dysfunction that, like I was saying, in our communities we come from. Because black women don't get, not all black women, but a lot of black women can't get along with each other because they want to be the queen bee on deck. Everybody's a queen bee in their own right, but you don't have to be the main queen bee just because you pull up into a situation. And if you deal with a man who has a child, you're going to have to understand that he's going to interact with his child's mother. You have to understand that. That comes with the territory. If not, then get a dude with no children. You know what I'm saying? And if he doesn't interact with his child's mother in a loving, honoring, respectful way, that's a red flag for yourself on how he's going to deal with you and your children if it don't work out. You know what I'm saying? But women always, oh, fuck, you know what I'm saying? Oh, this bitch, what you got to talk to her for? Like, come on. For real, at the end of the day, it's all because of the children. The children need both their parents, even if both the parents don't live in the same home. They need to know that both their parents is on deck whenever they need them. You know what I mean?
Right. Fact.
And the new chick that come into the picture that want to feel some type of way about, now I could certainly understand if you're talking to the child's mother that has nothing to do with the child and y'all still in each other's face like y'all a couple, I could certainly understand your,
right.
you know, your concern. I could certainly understand. Me, I wouldn't be putting up with that shit. I don't play that shit, nigga. If you want to go be with her, then go be with her. Don't come up in here with that bullshit. I'm not trying to stand in the way of you being there for your children, but don't disrespect me and my position that I'm trying to be in your life. You know what I'm saying? And if you do that,
you know what it
know
is,
what?
Though?
You could kick rocks.
I think there's an assumption of that, and that's the problem. You know,
and that's
it's almost like
though.
You
that's
can't have a cordial
though.
Relationship with the mother of your children. To,
right.
Oh, it's got to be some fucking going on. No, there's a
right.
reason why you in the picture because
though.
I dumped her or she dumped
right.
me, whatever the case is. We ain't together.
But the
right.
woman is always insecure, especially if she looks at the baby mother as being more attractive than her in her mind. You know what I'm saying? Or the woman is, you know, more together than her in her mind. It's an insecurity level. So when you – sometimes we come from dysfunction. We attract dysfunctional partners because of the dysfunction that we was raised in. So we attract the same energy that we vibrate on. You know what I mean? It's just – that's just
yeah.
how it works. You know what I mean?
I
so
remember
when
I was with my ex – I'm sorry. Well, I was with my ex and her daughter saw my ex. And
–
and me and my ex was beefing at the time. And her daughter was like, "Dang, Joseph, you used to date her?" it wasn't in a bad way. It was in a, "Wow, she's fine." Man,
right.
that
right.
was such a good day.
Of course, it's your ego,
that's
right?
That came out, but that was—I know I'm wrong, but I was dying
another
laughing
thing.
On the inside. I know that
another
had nothing
thing.
To do with anything, but I felt like saying
another
that.
Thing. Not to cut you off, King, because I know the time is limited. We're dealing with short time right now. But also, what causes the dysfunction and causes the friction between the man and the woman is ego. Nobody wants to sacrifice the ego for the best of the situation. You know, the woman, oh, no, this nigga think he gonna come up in here and tell me, and the man, nah, he better not have no niggas around my kids. Like, you're not with them, so you gotta expect that they're gonna date other people. Now, it's different if they're dating fucked up people and they're bringing that dysfunction in your child's life. Then you have a right to say something and step in. You know what I mean? But if, you know, you're not together, that ego, that, well, you know, like that territorial ego, because a lot of baby daddies and baby mamas have that territorial ego. You know what I'm saying? That, you know, just because
yeah.
I have your child or just because we have a child together, I got access to that pussy whenever the fuck I want. No, that's not how it works. Or I got access to that dick whenever the fuck I want. That's not how it's working, because that's creating more dysfunction in your new relationships, which is you're just going to have to live a fucked up cycle of dysfunctional relationships. You're always going to give your new partner insecurities because you're too much in your baby mama's face and it has nothing to do with the child. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Yeah, that's true.
And,
100%
you know,
true.
And with that being said, we have to realize how our actions don't just affect us, because our actions don't only affect us. You have to realize how our actions affect everybody around you in your life, because they do. People always want to think, oh, it's what I do in my life. Your life, especially if you have loved ones in your life, what happens to you in your life affects everybody. If you lose your life, everybody's affected. It's not just, oh, I lost my life. Oh, well, I'm going to put my life on the line. Oh, well, no, you got family members that give a damn about you. You got children. You got, you know what I'm saying? Everything you do in your life is not just for you. And that's where we fuck up at. We think it's all about us. And how we move is just going to affect us. And that's where we mess up at. I had to go through a lot to learn this. So I'm not just trying to act like I'm holier than thou when I always got the answers. But I've been through a lot in my life to understand this. You know what I mean? So.
Nah, you got all the answers, sweetheart.
No, I do not. I'm still.
You got all
the answers. Why you had to break out the Lou Rawls though?
You got
nah,
people. You got all the answers, sweetheart. You'll never find.
Y'all crazy.
You got all the answers.
I don't have all the answers. I just have a lot of experience and wisdom. I don't have all the answers. That's pretty much what's going on.
That's what I'm talking
about. Yeah. Yeah, and I'm probably older than all you. So.
what that mean?
My wisdom and experiences are a little different than yours. That's all.
No.
You know.
Not saying I know everything. Like I said, not say, listen. Not saying I know everything, because I don't. But I've been through a lot. You know what I'm saying? And what I've been through is my experience, is my wisdom, is my teacher. So I'm the space, mistakes I made, it's my job as a queen to inform those so they don't make the same mistakes that I made in my life. Because I ain't going to front. I was crazy freaking in my 20s, man. You know what I'm saying? But I've been through a lot. I learned from my mistakes, and I always want to pass on my wisdom to others because, you know, sometimes, like they say, when you know better, you do better. You know?
That's right.
So if you understand why I went through what I went through after I shared my experience with you, you'll be like, you know what? I ain't going to make that same mistake Kills made because, you know, it caused, you know, it didn't play out properly. And you want to have, everybody deserves love. Everybody wants happiness. Everybody wants the best for themselves and their children and their loved ones. If you don't, then you just the evil motherfucker. And you know what? The fuck you. You know what I'm saying? But everybody deserves to be happy at the end of the day. Why are you laughing?
On that note, Queen, before I disappear, we got to end the show.
All right.
I'm dying over here.
It was a pleasure. It was a pleasure.
I didn't drink half a gallon of water.
Queen, I love you. You make sure you call back next week.
Who's this? I don't even know who you are. I don't even know who you are. What is your name? What is your name on Facebook?
Yeah, oh, me?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's Jerome, Jerome.
I know how to spell Jerome.
The D is capital.
All right. Okay.
Really, bro?
Okay. He's talking to me like I'm some dumbass and shit. Okay. Like I just got off the little short yellow bus. Where my helmet at?
And on that note, folks, good night.
It's been real.
Right,
I appreciate
you know.
Y'all letting me rock out with y'all.
You know how we do. And before we go, man, please make sure you check out the groups, All Black Everything, My Skin Is My Sin, and I just started
Melanated, Proud, and Conscious.
Get your plug in. I just started a new
Melanated,
one
Proud,
Black
and Conscious.
Okay, you can't interrupt me now, though. I started a new one called the Black Polling Center. It's basically all we're going to do is have polls on here. You know, and the reason I did that is because I see a lot of polls on the news networks, and I have never once met a black person who has been called by a polling company. And I would like for us to be able to control our narrative. So when we get to, I mean, we got 400 people already in the group as of today, and it just started today. We get enough people to you don't have to make comments or anything, but if you're in there and you see a poll, respond to it, because we can submit these, and we can control our own narrative and start taking back this fucked up propaganda that they're using against us. On that note, man, love y'all. AJ, Rome, if y'all got anything to say, knock yourself out.
Be safe,
Black
family. Black first. Be safe. I'll let you next week.
And shout out to everybody in the chat room. DC Kemet, you nuts. Y'all have a good one. Man, peace out, and we'll see y'all next week.
Fashion emergency hotline.
Help! My mom doesn't think I need to go back to school.
You have to go to school. It's the law.
You didn't let me finish. She doesn't think I need to go back to school shopping.
That should be a law. Go to Old Navy. You'll be voted best dressed before school even starts.
Old Navy?
Yes. Right now, kids' clothes are up to 60% off.
60% off?
Yeah. The hallway will be your runway. They have awesome graphic tees, colorful active gear, and jeans start at just $10.
Now you're talking. Thank you.
Don't thank me. Thank Old Navy. Balance 728-92. Select styles only.
The following was recorded at a Burger King drive-thru at breakfast.
Morning, welcome to Burger King.
Let me get a sausage, egg, and cheese croissant sandwich.
Sure, right now they're 2 for $4, but is that how you say that?
Yeah, croissant sandwich.
Where I'm from, we say croissant sandwich. Try that.
Croissant sandwich!
Oh, that took you 2 seconds. Took me years of practice.
I'm not you.
Piled high with thick-cut bacon or savory sausage, fluffy eggs, and melted cheese. Get 2 croissant breakfast sandwiches for just $4. Only at Burger King. Limited time only. Price and participation vary. 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 Price and participation.